Hello all. Through this video, we would like to showcase a new technology called blockchain, its structure, its importance, and also answer an important question. Why is blockchain the solution to many security-related issues? Security, as we all think of, goes hand in hand with data privacy. But then security is also a big domain, and there are so many ways in which security breach can happen in an IoT device. In this video, we are going to talk about the different types of issues and what kind of research is being done on those areas. As we already know, IoT devices communicate with each other to extract data, which can give useful insights about the application for which it is used for. The current IoT systems rely mostly on the central entity taking decisions, for example, server. Thus, the chances of the central entity getting compromised is huge. Also, these devices are scattered geographically apart, and thus managing their communication through different barriers and handling different huge volume of data has become increasingly difficult. This has affected the security and the privacy of data. And this is the reason why we are going for something called as blockchains. Blockchain is a distributed ledger. As visible from the image, there is no master computer in blockchain, and thus all the nodes are peers and exchange information without any central party involved. We can safely say that blockchain is decentralized. Any information exchange must be agreed upon by all peers receiving the information. Thus, manipulating the information is never possible. Because it is a ledger, the new records or blocks are just added to the old records. The old records thus cannot be changed, and thus they are called as immutable records. Also, when messages are exchanged, smart contracts are created like an agreement between the different peers to enable trust and secure transmission. The verification for these contracts can be in the form of digital signatures or passwords or private keys of the account. Thus, using blockchain might be an answer to the security issues. There are several researches going on which are focused upon using blockchain as a means to secure the network. One of the most prominent examples, as we all know, is Bitcoin. Now, in this light, we can clearly see how a party requests for a transaction and that moves to all the peer groups. And this requesting creates a block, which is then broadcasted to everybody. They all take decisions and they all approve in this part, and only then the block is forwarded and is joined with the other records which are previously found. And this shows that the blockchain has been completed. And now this chain cannot be removed. This data cannot be removed any further from this record. Next, we move on to service-oriented architecture. We are now going to look at the service-oriented architecture, its different layers, and what blockchain can do for the service-oriented architecture. As we can see here, the physical layer, it will enable communication between the different devices which are connected to the gateways or the cloud from the diagram. Next, we move on to the network layer, where sharing up of data on the cloud and across the entire network is addressed. As you can see, the internet is connected to the physical layer as well as the service layers. Next, service layer. This layer seeks interoperation. It maintains a connection between the users, the other systems, and all the other business processes, and the network and the physical layer. So this is basically the layer wherein your services get exchanged and discovered. Now, for any architecture, we have something called as a requirement. So these are few requirements which can be needed or which are to be found in the physical layer. First one is interference, which is due to leaking faulty radio frequencies, and then insecure configuration and installation of hardware, spoofing attacks and environmental factors. All of these can be found in the physical layer, and these have to be avoided. So that is why they are a requirement. This is for the network layer, wherein you have limited resources of IoT devices. If, for example, the frame size of the transmission is less and a lot of work has to be done in reconstructing and splitting the packets, which is really difficult for the network layer to do. So we have to make sure that we have proper amount of resources and that there is no spoofing and that there's no overloading of any data or flooding of data. And even if there is any flooding of data, the layer is supposed to handle all these extra attacks. The next, we move on to the service layer. So insecure software, relying on a single server, having all the data, no proper quality of service requirement, or sending data to a decentralized server. All of these issues have to be addressed in the SOA architecture, but this is the traditional architecture in which these issues are found. So right now, before we move further, there's this axiomatic design theory is used to correlate the IoT devices and solutions. So basically, it is split into three different parts. One is the customer's domain, the functional domain, and the physical domain. The customer domain will talk about the requirements of the customer, what they want. It is from their viewpoint, which will be translated into functional requirements and what should actually happen in the device, what should be prevented in the device. And then the physical solution is how the attacks or how the requirements can be fulfilled, how they can, the attacks can be prevented. All of that will come under physical solutions. So basically, we'll have a functional requirement and we'll also have the physical solution. And this is the relation between the functional requirement and the physical solution. So we need a matrix, which is here represented as A. So this theory is actually saying that we need some design which will relate the functional requirements and the physical solutions.
Moving on, let us discuss the various aspects of blockchain for IoT security. The first physical solution we address here is for privacy. IoT, being a centralized system of nodes, has central authorities who access and control data from the devices. These are shared to third-party server or clouds without user concerns, leading to privacy breach. Cognoscenti proposed to integrate blockchain with decentralized private by design as the means to store private data. UDA, on the other hand, employed smart contracts as the main mechanism to generate tokens in blockchain ledger. Fair access is an architectural framework addressed the issue of device distribution, handled a large quantity of data, and coped with the resource-constrained devices. Whereas the downside of fair access was that it positioned at an organizational level where the detailed implementation of policy enforcement to devices inside an organization was unclear. In addition, as a part of blockchain, consensus protocols used to determine the system performance was mentioned, and the protocol used in fair access caused a significant delay in accessing permission tokens. And also, device mobility is infeasible since it requires the transfer of authorities. Access control is normally exercised to protect security and privacy, and many existing protocols have been proposed, but without considering IoT characteristics such as constrained environments. We need access control to avoid IP spoofing and forgery. The complexity for access control deployment must be concerned as a result from diversity and difference of IoT computational capabilities. Moving on, the next security concern is authentication. Due to resource limitations, sophisticated mechanisms cannot be applicable to IoT applications of centralized systems. Hence, blockchain technology uses the private and public key pairs for identities and authentication can be employed. Some of the proposed techniques are by Kravitz and Cooper, who applied key rotation, which enabled recording of expired and updated blocks. One of the other research is by Kaga, devised a new digital signature scheme to avoid identity theft by incorporating biometric signature called PBI. The latest research by Hami also discusses methodology with an administrator designing the smart contracts and the master controlling it. The increasing capabilities of IoT devices and a large production of data are shifting computing models from centralized cloud-based platforms towards the network edges of IoT. Cloud-based platforms are considered inefficient to satisfy future requirements when the higher volumes of data needs to be transmitted to remote clouds. Since this incurs high latency, consumes a lot of bandwidth, and requires complex applications for processing, blockchain technology comes in handy. Sharma, in his recent research, presented a blockchain which integrates Fox IoT devices and clouds. Bufari used social network platform like TweetChain, wherein sufficient number of tweets would form a meshed network leading to a blockchain. Dori proposed a lightweight, scalable blockchain to alleviate the problem of resource scarcity in IoT devices. There are many security risks for data exchange and sharing in a trustable way at every stage. Traditionally, the cloud-based third-party auditor is applied to guarantee the trust of data throughout the data lifecycle, but this cannot be blindly trusted. Liu proposed a BCT-based framework using smart contracts and consensus like POW to ensure the integrity of data in cloud storage service. This, however, could not be implemented as it doesn't support scalability. On the other hand, Shafak, in his research, implemented an architecture with different layers to perform different functions. For example, the data layer to handle data operations, a control layer to access and key management, etc. In short, two trends exist for data sharing. The first trend is to equip cloud with a BCT to ensure integrity of data. The blockchain is lightweight as it only needs to ensure data integrity. The second trend is to design a new blockchain architecture to eliminate the need for cloud platform. The service of integrating IoT and blockchain often implements a RESTful protocol to provide functionalities from one or more IoT components. This shift has attracted many researchers to think about new landscape of trust models to be applied in distributed environments. One of the main issues which determines trust of the component is software installation and version control behind their executions. Samangyo and Dieters proposed to combine virtual resources with permission blockchain service as a trusted repository. Dori, in a vehicular systems to facilitate software update on electronic control units. Authenticated manufacturers installed new updates on cloud, and the fingerprint of the codes were signed by multiple entities. While the above works could work, could install the updates accurately, they were not able to deal with the consistency of software installations. It was common to have multiple versions of software, and that it left the vulnerabilities of the system for using an outdated version. The prevalence of IoT devices has led to ubiquitous services worldwide. Services with similar functionalities will be available, and the services can be selected optimally based on QoS. However, an important issue is the trustworthiness of QoS, which is maintained by authorized or peer entities. There is a need for QoS schemes to be improved to deal with the processes such as device registration, mobility of devices, etc. Ruta presented in his research a semantic web of things, and McCaukey employed KPI to establish the trust of entities. Viryasithwath introduced a blockchain-based QoS management system that provided the trusted QoS information to users. Securing network protocol. The network protocol for IoT targets is designed to transmit data over low power and unstable networks. IoT devices are generally unsuitable to the operations which require high computing, for example, complex encryption of traditional protocols such as VPN and SSL. One of the suggested researches on LoRaWAN mandated the collection and transmission of data and sometimes controlled external systems. But there's a huge disadvantage of this is malicious message injection, message forgery, and flooding attacks. The presented works did not consider design criteria such as time delay, latency, load quantities, practicalities, and incentive models. Process control. Devices are communicated in the network and the tasks that they are performing are coordinated by process definitions. The IEC 161499 standard is developed to control the distributed systems by defining the requirements for inputs, outputs, and algorithms. To address this, the ongoing research by Stanshu reported their ongoing study to use Hyperledger Fabric as a blockchain-based platform for IEC 61499 compliance. However, the work was limited to the conceptual design stage and no detail was revealed on the implementation. Development platform. The integration of IoT and blockchain is very new and standards and common practices for developing are immature. The problem manifests in insecure configurations or misconfigurations of Ethereum smart contracts. One of the proposed solution is Platybot is a platform for repeated tests on the integrated applications. The demonstration were conducted in the Ethereum. The actor pattern was applied with domain specification language to define clients in the network via DSL configuration files. The tested criteria included the order of executions and detections and lost transactions on the blockchain. In this paper by Batana and Zooming, the development of an IoT application is treated as a system design problem and the ADD is used as a framework to map the existing peers to FRs in order to identify FRs which are important but still ignored. The functional requirements of security for SOA-based applications is given by as follows, and the physical solutions to security assurance of SOA-based applications is given by the following. Now, using the data in Table 1, the PSS and the FRs discussed in the previous slide, we apply the ADC which yields the relational matrix A of FRs and PSS. Further, the rank order clustering algorithm is applied to gain more understanding of the mapping between the FRs and PSS. Some of the concluding remarks which we can get from this analysis is that an ad hoc way fails to address security threats in IoT, and there is a need for a systematic design approach to assure security. Blockchain is not the solution to all threats. As seen from evaluation, no work has been developed to address threats. FR14, that is a physical security, and FR21, that is resource depletion. Quoting examples of the highlighted groups in 5, it is ideal to combine the PSS A, B, and C as a holistic solution for the functional requirements of FR 11, 12, 32, and 34. Conclusion, As per the observations obtained from the paper, we can say that the researchers on implementing blockchain on IoT devices have led to discovery of how the blockchain can be maintained and managed. Each of the methods employed for research expresses the importance of security of an IoT device. Future work can be on how to implement a blockchain which can be used for scalable devices, cope with billions of data, and yet stay compatible with the devices. Here is our list of research papers used for this discussion.